Do you know what factors increase your cardiovascular risk the most? If you're on statins, your doctor at least thinks it's cholesterol. I mean, after all, that's what statins do. They lower your cholesterol. In this video, we'll explore this question and the related question of whether you can know if statins have actually helped you avoid a heart attack. Stay tuned. I'm going to start with a little anecdote. Back in 2008, when I was 51, I got off statins for a short while, and as you might expect, my cholesterol numbers went up. Now, my doctor had a very swift, strong, and unambiguous reaction to that. Her office called me, asked me if I had gotten off statins, told me I had to get right back onto them or I was in extreme danger. So I can't hold them responsible for not having the 2018 pooled cohort equation risk calculator. This was 2008 after all. But I could expect them to give me a good feel for what my risk actually was. Was it high, so high that it wasn't a matter of if I was going to have a heart attack, but when? Was it a moderate 10-year risk? Was it a mild 10-year risk? Or was it a small 10-year risk? Well, with the benefit of hindsight and the availability of the 2018 calculator, I plugged my numbers in from back then, went back in time, said I'm 51, here's my numbers. My 10-year risk was 4.6%. And if I had taken a statin, in theory, that would have reduced it to 3%. Did you see that little move there? That's how much benefit I could get from taking a statin, in theory. So this got me to thinking, what factors do these calculators actually, how much weight do they give to them? I mean, I can look at the formula, but it's so complex. If you saw my earlier video on what the formulas are, impossible to figure out from looking at that. You just have to experiment. So here's where I got the 4.6%. Okay, doesn't matter. That's the past, water under the bridge. So I tried finding by the calculator's measures a healthy person my age, put in my numbers of my blood pressure average. I don't smoke, I don't have diabetes, and I had an HDL of around 49. Not the greatest, I'd like it to get up into 50 and 60, not there yet. And instead, my total cholesterol, I put in a total cholesterol into the calculator that finally got the risk down to 5%. So okay, now we have a standard defined 65-year-old. According to them, this is healthy. We can argue with the 160, but let's just go with it for now. Okay, so let's go back to my current numbers, which means adding about 67% to my total cholesterol. From 160 up to 268. The 10-year risk goes up to 7.5%. Okay, something to be concerned about, something for me to watch. So instead, let's go back down to 160 total cholesterol, and let's increase blood pressure by 67%. In other words, the systolic blood pressure gone from 118 to 198. The 10-year risk goes up to 22.5%. That's like 1 out of 4.5 people in this condition are going to have a heart attack over the next 10 years. Heart attack or other cardiovascular event. Kind of scary. Well, let's treat that person's blood pressure. And we treat it with medication. We get it back down to 118. According to the calculator, yeah, that's a great improvement, but it's not as good as having that blood pressure naturally. It only gets us down to 7.2%. Okay, just keep these numbers in mind. Okay, now we're going to take this healthy 65-year-old, give him back his normal blood pressure without medication, and we're going to make him a smoker. Well, in that case, the risk goes up to 11.5%. Let's say he's not a smoker and has type 2 diabetes. His risk is up to 11%. Well, we look at this and I say, well, out of all these numbers I've come up with, that 198 blood pressure, that's kind of not realistic. I mean, that's extremely high blood pressure, and maybe raising cholesterol by 67%, we shouldn't expect it to be the same as raising blood pressure by 67%. So then I ask the question, how much would I have to raise my blood pressure to get to that same 7.5% 10-year risk level that matches the increase of 108 points on the total cholesterol? And that was a blood pressure of 135. That's still pre-hypertensive. That's up by about 14%. So let's keep these things in mind. You can go and experiment with your own numbers and see what factors are going to increase or decrease your risk, according to the calculator at least. So this is what struck me in all that. These factors all contribute more to cardiovascular event risk than does cholesterol. Your age, can't do anything about that. It is what it is. Smoking, you can do something about that. type 2 diabetes. You can do something about that. I recommend you go to the Beat Diabetes channel. Dennis Pollack runs it. It's an excellent channel. Can help you deal with type 2 diabetes. And high blood pressure. All these factors have a larger impact on your cardiovascular risk than your cholesterol total does. So I'm going to look at a related question, and that is what I call the statin treatment paradox. And we're going to perform a thought experiment. We're going to take 200 people. We're going to give 100 of them statins, and the other 100 are just going to be our control group. This is a thought experiment. It's not really doing this. And we're going to assume each one of them has an 11% risk. So let's fill out this chart that you see. Among the people who don't take a statin and don't have a cardiovascular event, well, that's 89 of them. Now, there is a small improvement statistically, whether it's from lowering cholesterol, like many doctors insist, or it's from reducing inflammation, like other doctors say it is. 93 people in the statin group won't have a cardiovascular event. Of the people not taking a statin, 11 of them presumably will, because they had that 11% risk. And at the end of that 10 years, 7 people who took statins are still going to have a heart attack. Let's dig a little deeper here. Out of those 89 people who didn't take statins and didn't have a heart attack, and I'll just say heart attack, understand, I mean cardiovascular events in general, the statin wasn't needed. They didn't take it and they didn't have a heart attack. Out of the 93 people who didn't have heart attacks in the statin group, for any individual, we don't know whether the statin helped them or not. And in fact, there's a 95.7% chance that the statin didn't make any difference at all, because presumably 89 out of those 93 people weren't going to have a heart attack. Well, 89 divided by 93 is 95.7%. There is a 4.3% chance that the reason they didn't have the heart attack, they're one of those 4 extra people who didn't have heart attacks, was because of the statin. Among the people who had heart attacks and didn't take a statin, well, we don't know if taking a statin would have helped them or not, because 7 people who took statins, the statins didn't help them. So that means there's a 36% chance that the statin would have helped, and a 64% chance that it wouldn't have helped. And I actually got those numbers from Lipitor. I actually got these figures here, the 11 and the 7, come from the 36%, not the other way around. Just using the standard Lipitor clinical trial results that Pfizer advertised. So the question comes up, what's the criteria for getting off a statin? So we look at that right column there. Well, out of those 93 people, 95.7% of them didn't make any difference, but we don't know who they are. So the doctor's not going to tell them, well, you get off a statin, you didn't have a heart attack, because the doctor's going to say the reason you didn't have a heart attack may be because you were on a statin. And the people who had the heart attacks, despite being on a statin, well, the feeling there is that, oh, once you've had a heart attack, now you're into secondary prevention, and statins are much more effective in preventing second heart attacks. Well, that's only true in a kind of a statistical manner, where if a person has had a heart attack and wasn't on statins, then you put them on a statin, yeah, it seems to improve things a bit because they're at a higher risk. I mean, once you've had a heart attack, that's another thing that gives you a higher risk. It's not in the calculators, by the way. I find that interesting. Calculators are for people who have not had a prior event. So the statin didn't help, but they're going to want you to stay on it because of this flawed reasoning. So there is no criteria for getting off a statin. We know whether it was not needed, and we have a way of knowing that it didn't help, though they throw that exception at us, and all the rest of the states are ambiguous. So once you're on a statin, the medical profession's position is you have to stay on them regardless of what happens. So here's some medicine for thought. The effectiveness of statins are greatly exaggerated, and for individuals, it can't be known with any certainty. That's those yellow circles on the previous chart as far as not knowing for an individual the certainty, with any certainty, whether the statin helped. The greatly exaggerated, my doctor's office, when she called me up, her office manager called me up in a panic that my cholesterol values had gone up. I asked the doctor, hey, could there be such a thing as a rebound effect where my cholesterol goes up a little bit more before it settles back down to its natural level? And no, that absolutely can't happen. Well, it went down 20 points from just doing nothing. There's no clear criteria for getting off statins if they're ineffective, because there's no clear way of telling if they're ineffective or not. Well, other than you have a heart attack when you are on them, but that trots out that exception there. And the risks are often misunderstood, and as a result, are also exaggerated. In other words, remember my cholesterol going way up to 289, which increased my risk. To them, it was a 50% increase in a risk, but they didn't stop to consider that it was a very low risk. I don't think they really knew it was a very low risk. I think that the doctor's office was as much a victim of the cholesterol panic as a lot of patients are. So that's my quick take on the factors that go into your cardiovascular risk and the problems with trying to figure out when it's time to get off statin. That's not on anybody's radar. Getting off statins is just not something that the doctor is going to be considering for you. It's a decision you'll have to make yourself if that's the way you're going to go. So if you appreciate this content, please like, share, subscribe, and comment. And if you haven't seen this video, I recommend you take a look at it now. Thanks for listening.